Tapes and Scouts, a podcast where two friends review every single movie they watch.
Little bit different around
here. You're coming over here to Chinatown.
Ooh.
This film is 1974, if you're not familiar. Watched it on January 15th, 2023. It is 2 hours and 10 minutes. Mystery drama directed by the very questionable Roman Polanski, starring Jack Nicholson, Faye Dunaway, and John Huston. Your movie summary: private detective hired to expose an adulterer in 1930s Los Angeles finds himself caught up in a web of deceit, corruption, and murder.
And murder?
And murder.
And murder?
And murder.
And
This is another tough movie to talk about because it is so well regarded. And for obvious reason, when you watch it, it is a phenomenally well-done film. It's one of Roman Polanski's strongest. Everybody knows the forget it, Jake. It's Chinatown line at the end.
Yep.
I think a lot of people know the conceit of this film, which for the time was very nefarious.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like kind of tears away all the chuff and is pretty raw look at like underneath of everything. And no matter how grand you may think something is, when you kind of cut away all the clutter, there's some terrible, small, like kind of truth, no matter how big the person is that you're investigating or wrapped up in. It's really like brutally honest. Like no matter how far away we go to try to escape something, reality will come back and bite us in the ass.
Always.
No matter what. And I think this movie typifies that. I mean, there's so much here. To talk about the good would take much longer than the way this is formulated to go in terms of how we do these two-handers, but the things that don't work for me in this movie are like super few and far between. Like I don't think there's anything wrong here with it. The two hours and 10 minutes does not drag in any regard.
Right.
It sets up, you do your point there, great setups and payoffs. I mean, it's just so good. It's got Burt Young in it, who's Paulie from Rocky, and he's in at the beginning as like a throwaway character, and he shows up again at the end. It's a nice little
That's fun.
They didn't have to do that.
I wish I remembered this better. I saw this.
Part of the reason I wanted to go back and revisit it is kind of like Sam had never seen it before because Sam's one of those folks who doesn't watch older films too much. And she's like, oh, it's old. I don't like that. It's old.
What did we determine Sam's golden age was? 1983? The golden age of cinema?
Something like that.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if it goes before that for her, if it goes before. I mean, it's tough. Anything pre-2000, it's hard to sell her on. Like, she's like, oh, that's old.
In the year 2000?
In the year 2000.
Yes.
Star Wars was 77, Jurassic Park was 95, 93.
One of those.
93, because 91 was Terminator 2.
Fair.
So it's it was a tough sell to get her to watch. I was like, oh, I kind of want to watch it. She just wanted to watch a movie, and she was like, fine, if you sit here and watch a movie, whatever, well, I'll watch this
fine,
one.
Fine, I'll watch some good movie.
I think she enjoyed it on the whole, and I mean, it's timeless. Everybody knows it. And there's good reason, despite, again, the very questionable Roman Polanski.
Yeah.
But I don't mind. And I know this is a deeper discussion. So let us know in the comments how you feel about the art-artist subject. I personally can separate I'm evaluating the film.
Right.
I will certainly use the filmmaker from an artistic perspective to help understand the film or to like understand how they made choices artistically. But outside of kind of viewing the film as a piece and the art and the creator as an artist, I'm not going to get into personal politics and things. I've watched movies by deplorable people and amazing people, and I would review them the same because I'm reviewing the film, not necessarily the filmmaker.
That's right.
They're responsible at the end of the day for it, but that's kind of where my analysis ends.
Hey, maybe we'll end up doing Twitch where we just talk shit on everybody.
Right?
Talk shit episode.
Let us know if you want to see something like that.
Yeah.
IMDb gives this one an 8.2 out of 10. IMDb starting with an 8 is rare.
That's very good, yeah.
Yeah. Rotten Tomatoes critics, 78 critics, 99%.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Nice.
Audience, 50,000 plus. How do you think the audience feels about Chinatown? 50,000 plus.
I don't think it's going to be as good as that critical score. I think it's going to be actually lower than IMDb. I'm going to say like 76.
93%.
Well, crap.
Yeah, no, surprising, right? Like, you would figure the audience might be like, this is a little too heavy.
Sure.
Or this is a little too, like, long-winded tends to be the, you know what I mean, like, things took longer. You didn't just go cut, 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 cut. You know what I mean? It was nice and let the scene play out. So surprising to see that many people go. I mean, 50,000 plus isn't just people who are interested in film school, I don't think. I think it's people who want it, who just kind of happened upon it for one reason or another.
For sure.
And I give it a 9.5 out of 10. Movie's phenomenal.
9.5.
Just woo. Can't. To the rare 9, not as rare 9.5 for me. I tend to spread my scores out across the spectrum.
Yeah.
Tim, every 0.5 counts a ton.
It does.
It does.
It does.
It really does.